Question number 11. First part. You have to find the domain of the following real functions. Function x is given. Root of x minus 2. So for domain of a function, fx must be a real number. It means for df, this root of x minus 2 must be a real number. When it will be a real number? When x minus 2 is greater than equal to 0, because it is in root. So root negative will be what? Imaginary number. So you want greater than equal to 0 means x is greater than equal to minus 2 will go that way. So x is greater than equal to 2. So domain of a function will be what? More than 2. And 2 is included, so 2 comma infinity we can't touch. Second part, fx is equal to root of 2 minus 3x. So for domain of a function, fx must be a real number. So root of 2 minus 3x must be a real number. It means 2 minus 3x is always greater than equal to 0. So 2 is greater than equal to 3x. Or you can write 2 by 3 is greater than equal to x. This 3 will come down. Or you can say x is less than equal to 2 by 3. X is less than equal to 2 by 3. It means it is going left hand side. So less than equal to 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 is the maximum value. Comma, it can go till minus infinity. So domain of a function is what? Minus infinity. We can't touch. Comma, 2 by 3. Now third part. Third part, you can see, question number 11 only. Third part, fx is equal to 1 upon root of x minus 1. So for df, for domain of a function, this fx must be a real number. So 1 upon root of x minus 1 must be a real number. So x minus 1, down it is x minus 1. So x minus 1 is greater than 0. It can't be greater than and equal to 0. If it is equal to 0 means what? 1 upon 0 will come, so we can't define it. So x minus 1 should be greater than 0. So x is greater than equal to greater than 1. Greater than 1, but 1 is not included. So domain of a function is what? 1. This bracket, comma, infinity. This is the domain of a function. Now question number 11th, fourth part. Fx is equal to 1 upon root of 3 minus x. For df, domain of a function, this fx must be a real number, means 1 upon root of 3 minus x must be a real number. Is it clear? So when it will be a real number? When this part will be greater than 0. And it is down, so I can't take equal to 0. So 3 minus x should be greater than 0. 3 is greater than x, or I can say x is less than, the x value is less than 3. X value is less than 3, it means domain of a function is less than 3. So 3 is the maximum value. Less than 0 can go to minus infinity comma 3. Is it clear? Less than 3. So it is negative side. So 3 comma minus 3. From that side 3, this side minus infinity. Now question number 12. Question number 12th, you can see, find the domain of the following real functions. Fx is equal to mod of x plus. So for domain of a function df, fx must be a real number. X plus 2 must be a real number. So these all are what? Real functions. So for every real value of x, this mod of x plus 2 will be a real number. So for all x belongs to, for all x belongs to real numbers, this mod of x plus 2 will be a real number. So I can say domain of a function is all real numbers. Second part, fx is equal to minus mod of x minus 2. So for df, for domain of a function, this must be a minus mod of x minus 2 must be a real number. So you know, anything you put here, any value of x which belongs to the real number, this mod of minus mod of x minus 2 will be a real number. So again here, domain of a function will be what? A real number. Is it clear? Now third part. third part, fx is equal to 2 minus mod of x minus 1. 2 minus mod of x minus 1. So for df, for domain of a function, this must be a real number. 2 minus mod of x minus 1. So you know which is a real number. This will be a real number only, which is a real number for all x belongs to real numbers. Is it clear? Now, 4. So domain here is what? Domain of f is what? All real numbers. Fourth part, fx is equal to mod of x minus x, mod of x minus x upon 2x. Here, for df, for finding df, domain of a function, this must be a real number. Mod of x minus x upon 2x must be a real number. Must be a real number. For all real numbers, it will be a real number only. Only x is not equal to 0. We don't know. 2x can't be equal to 0. This down part is not equal to 0. Means x is not equal to 0. Apart from all values of a real number, all real numbers you can take. But from 0. So, domain of function is what? All real numbers, only you have to exclude 0. Now, question number 13. Question number 13. Find the range of the following functions. You have to find the range. Find the range. You have to find the range of the following functions. First function is given. Fx is equal to x square plus 2. Fx is equal to x square plus 2. Such that x belongs to all real numbers. X belongs to real numbers. So, fx is equal to x square plus 2. It means, you have to start from here. Let x be any real number. Let x be any real number. Let x be any real number. So, if x is any real number, so x square will be always greater than or equal to 0. X square is greater than or equal to 0. If let x be any real number, x square is greater than or equal to 0. Or x square plus 2 is greater than or equal to 0. Always x square is greater than or equal to 0. If I take 0 also, 0 square is what? Greater than or equal to 0. 0 is equal to 0. So from greater and equal, equal is matching. So for any real number x, x square is greater than or equal to 0. From where to start, I will tell you. Here, what is the function? X square plus 2. So first take x be any real number. Then write whatever is given here. X square is greater than or equal to 0. We know that x square will be always greater than or equal to 0. If I write plus 2, then it will be what? 0 plus 2 both sides. X square plus 2, I have to make this function. So I will add plus 2. So here also I have to add plus 2. So x square plus 2 is greater than or equal to what? 2. It, x square plus 2 is what? F of x is greater than or equal to what? 2. F of x is what actually? That is the y is greater than or equal to 2. Y is what? Range fx is only y. This is what? Image of x. So y is always greater than or equal to 2, or you can say range greater than or equal to 2. It means 2 is included, comma infinity we can't touch. Like this you have to solve. Now second part. Question number 13. Second part you can see. Question number 13. Second part you can see. Fx is equal to 3 minus 2x. Fx is equal to 3 minus 2x. Fx is equal to 3 minus 2x. X belongs to real numbers. And x is greater than or equal to 1. You can't take less than 1. X is greater than or equal to 1. That is the condition, and x belongs to real numbers. Fx is equal to 3 minus 2x. Here you see. 2x. So I have to make this function. So first I will start. Let x be any real number. Let x be any real number. And here it is already given that x is greater than or equal to 1. X is greater than or equal to 1. Now I have to make this function. So here you can see it is 2x. So multiply with 2. 2x is greater than or equal to 1 into 2. So 2x is greater than or equal to 2. 2x is greater than or equal to 2. Now here it is what? minus 2x. I will tell you, if 5 is greater than equal to 3, it is written. 5 is greater than equal to 3. So if I write minus 5, so minus 5, so I have to do minus 5, but minus 5 is not greater than equal to minus 3. The sign will change when you multiply with minus. Is it clear? So if 2x is greater than equal to 2, but here I want what? Minus 2x, so if I am doing minus 2x, this sign will change less than equal to, it will be minus 2. It is clear? Minus 2x is less than equal to minus 2. Now here it is what? 3 minus 2x, so add plus 3 both the sides. So it will be what? 3 minus 2x less than equal to 3 minus 2. So this is what? Our function 3 minus 2x is less than equal to 1. It means what? Y is less than equal to 1. Fx is equal to what? Y, that is the range. The range is equal to what? Less than equal to 1 means going to negative side. Less than 1. So maximum is what? 1 less than 1. So minus infinity. Minus infinity we can't touch. It is clear? Now question number 14. You can see. Find the domain and range of the following function. Both you have to find range and domain and range of the following function. Fx is equal to 2x square plus 1. Also find f of minus 2. Then you have to find f of minus 2 also. Find f of minus 2 and the numbers which are associated with the number 51 in its range. And numbers associated with. This you have to find. First, fx is equal to 2x square plus 1. So start from here only. For domain of f, fx must be a real number, means 2x square plus 1 must be a real number. This should be a real number. So, you know, any value of x you put, if it is a real number, this 2x square plus 1 will be a real number. So for all x belongs to a real number, this 2x square plus 1 will be a real number only. Will be a real number only. It means domain of a function. Domain of a function is what? All real numbers. So df is what? R. Is it clear? So for range of a function, let y is equal to fx. Let, you have to start like this. Let y is equal to f of x is equal to what? 2x square plus 1. Range you have to find means you have to find the value of y or fx. Is it clear? So we know that for all x belongs to real number, x square is greater than equal to what? 0. So for, we have to write here, we know that for, you have to find, actually we are, we have to find range. Range means what? Values of y. Y you have to find. It means you have to let y is equal to fx is equal to 2x square plus 1. And we know that for all x belongs to real numbers, x square is greater than equal to 0. Again I have to make this function. X square is greater than equal to 0. Now I want here what? 2x. If x square is greater than equal to 0 means what? 2x square is greater than equal to what? 2 into 0 means what? 2 into 0. Multiplying both the sides because I want here 2x square plus 1. So first step by step. X square is greater than equal to 0. Next multiplied with 2. 2x square is greater than equal to 2 into 0. Then it is what? 2x square is greater than equal to 0. But here you want 2x square plus 1. So add both the sides plus 1. 2x square plus 1 is greater than equal to 0 plus 1. It means 2x square plus 1 is greater than equal to 1. 2x square plus 1 means what? Fx, that is what? Function of x is greater than equal to 1 or y value is greater than equal to 1. That is what? Range is greater than equal to 1. So range of a function is what? Greater than equal to 1. So 1 is minimum, then comma infinity maximum, greater than equal to, this is the range. It is clear? Now you have to find f of minus 2. You can do f of minus 2. F of minus 2. So you can substitute here 2 into minus 2 square plus 1. 2 into minus 2 square 4. 4 2 is 8. 8 plus 1 9. So f of minus 2 is equal to 9. Now they are asking. And the numbers which are associated with the numbers 51 in its range means fx is equal to 1. 51. You have to find the value of x. So fx is equal to 51 means 2x square plus 1 is equal to 51. 2x square is equal to 51. This plus 1 will go that side to minus 1. So 2x square is equal to 50x square is equal to 50 by 2. That is what? 25. X square is equal to 25. It means x is equal to plus minus root of 25. Plus minus 5. So from x and here y. This plus 5 and minus 5. Both are associated with 25. It is clear? Both are associated with 25. Is it clear? So plus 5 and minus 5 are associated with this 51. Now question number 15. You can see here. Find the domain and range of the following functions. First part you have to do. Fx is equal to root of x plus 2. Fx is equal to root of x plus 2. So you know for domain of a function, fx must be a real number means root of x plus 2 must be a real number. Is it clear? So x plus 2. Root of x plus 2. X plus 2 is greater than equal to what? 0. It can be 0 also because it is not upon. So it is not 1 upon root of x plus 2. If it is 1 upon root of x plus 2 means x plus 2 can be greater than 0. It is not equal to 0. So x plus 2 is greater than equal to 0. It means x plus 2 is greater than equal to 0. X is greater than equal to minus. 2 plus 2 will go that side. So x is greater than equal to minus 2. Or domain of a function is what? Greater than equal to minus 2. Greater than equal to minus 2. It means minus 2 comma infinity. We can't touch. Now for range of a function, what is the range? What will be the range? If it is minus 2, range will be what? It is minus 2 to infinity. If it is minus 2, it means what? Minus 2 plus 2 is what? 0. So it is, this is 0, comma. If this is infinity, so it is also infinity. So range of function is like this. Or you can write like this. Let y is equal to root of x plus 2. Y is equal to x plus 2. Since x belongs to real numbers, for all x belongs to R, root of x plus 2 must be a real number. Root of x plus 2 must be greater than equal to 0. This is paka. For all x belongs to R, x plus 2 also belongs to R, or x plus 2 is greater than equal to 0. You can directly also write, or if you want to write this, you can write, let y is equal to fx is equal to root of x plus 2. Since, you can write like this, since root of x plus 2 is always greater than equal to 0, for all x belongs to R. For all x belongs to R, x plus 2 is greater than equal to, root of x plus 2 is always greater than equal to 0. So I can say, here already we proved that root of x plus 2 must be a real number. Means if it is a real number, so this is greater than equal to 0, or x plus 2 is greater than equal to 0. So since this is greater than equal to 0 for all x belongs to R, means what? Y, this value is 1. Y is equal to fx, so y is greater than equal to 0. For all x belongs to R. For all x belongs to R, or I can say range of a function is equal to 0, comma, infinity. Or directly also you can see minus 2. If value is minus 2, so minus 2 plus 2 is what? 0, root of 0 is what? 0 only, comma, infinity. Infinity plus 2 is, that is what? Infinity. So, if the domain of function is what? Minus 2 comma infinity, minus 2 you can touch, or this value is included. So, 0 value is also included, comma infinity you can touch. Like this. Now, second part, question number 15, second part. Second part, fx is equal to root of 3 minus 2x. So for domain of a function, this fx was to be a real number, it should be a, must be a real number. If it is a real number, it means what? 3 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 0, or 3 is greater than or equal to 2x, or x is, or you can write 3 by 2 is greater than or equal to x, or x is less than or equal to 3 by 2. Less than or equal to 3 by 2, it means going to left hand side. So minus infinity, comma, 3 by 2, maximum value of 3 by 2, and less than. So this is the domain of a function. It is clear, this is the domain of a function. Now, for RF, for range of a function, for RF, let y is equal to, like this you can write, directly also you can do, let y is equal to fx is equal to what? Root of 3 minus 2x. As you know, x is, here you can use this value, x is less than or equal to 3 by 2. X is less than or equal to 3 by 2. Now you have to make this value, 3 minus 2x. X is less than or equal to 3 by 2. I want 3 minus 2x, so I will multiply. 2x is less than or equal to 1. 2 into 3 by 2 to cancel. So 2x is less than or equal to 3. 2x is less than or equal to, you want here 3 minus 2x first. So I will do minus 2x. If I am multiplying with minus, sign will change. It will be greater than or equal to minus 3. If it is less than or equal, 2x is less than or equal to 3, but I am doing minus 2x. So I will do greater than or equal to minus 3. It is clear. Now you want 3 minus 2x, so add both sides 3. 3 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 3 minus 3. It means this is the function. Function of x is greater than or equal to what? 0. Fx is greater than or equal to 0. Or 3 minus 2x. 1 minute. 3 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 0. Or if 3 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 0, you can write here, 3 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 0. Or if I do root of, if 3 minus 2x is greater than or equal to 0, means what? Root 3 of minus 2x is also greater than or equal to 0. Root of 3 minus 2x is what? Fx. So fx is greater than or equal to 0. So range of function will be what? Range will be what? Greater than or equal to 0. So 0 is included, 0 comma infinity. This is the range. Is it clear? Now, question number 15, third part. Question number 15, third part only. Fx is equal to 1 upon root of x minus 5. Fx is equal to 1 upon root of x minus 5. You know, for domain of a function, fx must be a real number, means 1 upon root of x minus 5 must be a real number. When it will be a real number? When this part, this is down. So it is not greater than or equal to 0. So x minus 5 is only greater than 0. I can't take greater than or equal to 0, because if it will be 0, then we can't define the function. So x minus 5 is greater than 0, or x is greater than 1. 5. X is greater than 5, so domain of a function is greater than 5. 5 is not included, so I am writing 5. I am not writing this bracket. I am writing this bracket. 5 comma infinity, I can't touch. So this is the domain of a function. Now, for RF, range of a function, how will you do? For range of a function, how will you start? For range of a function, let y is equal to fx is equal to what? 1 upon root of x minus 5. So, you know, x is greater than what? 5. Already we did that x minus 5. Well, finding for df, fx must be a real number, means x minus 5 is greater than 0. So, x is greater than what? 5. So, start from here. As x is greater than 5. X is greater than 5. So, you want here what? Root of x minus 5. So, step by step, x minus 5 you need. So, x minus 5. Here also you do minus 5. So, x minus 5 is greater than what? 0. If x minus 5 is greater than 0, it means what? Root of x minus 5 is also greater than 0. Root of x minus 5 is greater than 0. It means what? 1 upon root of x minus 5 is also greater than 0. Or you can say y is greater than 0. Or f of x is greater than 0. This is the same function. 1 upon root of x minus 5 is greater than 0. Greater than 0. Y is greater than 0, not equal to. So, range of function will be 0. Greater, equal sign is not there. So, 0 comma infinity. This is the range. Is it clear? Okay, now question number 16. Question number 16. You can see. Find the domain and range of the following functions. First function. F of x is equal to 4 minus x upon x minus 4. So you know for df, domain of a function. Fx must be a real number, means 4 minus x upon x minus 4 must be a real number. It should be a real number. So this should be a real number. When it will be a real number? When x minus 4 is greater than, is not equal to 0. You can directly write when x minus 4 is not equal to 0. Or x is not equal to 4. This minus 4 will go that side. Or add 4 for both sides. So you will get x is not equal to 4. So domain of a function is what? All real numbers. Only 4 is not included. When the value is 4, the function is not a real number. So all real numbers minus exclude 4. Is it clear? For RF, for range of a function, for RF, let y is equal to fx is equal to what? 4 minus x upon x minus 4. Is it clear? 4 minus x upon x minus 4 is equal to what? I can write minus common. It will be x minus 4 upon x minus 4. X minus 4 to x minus 4 cancel. That is fx is equal to what? So y value directly it is coming what? Minus 1. So range of a function is what? RF is equal to minus 1. Now second part. Question number 16, second part. Fx is equal to x square minus 9 upon x minus 3. So start from here. For domain of a function, fx must be a real number, means x square minus 9 upon x minus 3 must be a real number. It should be a real number. When it will be a real number? When x minus 3 is not equal to 0, or x minus x is not equal to 3. X is not equal to 3. So you can't take value 3 in the domain. Otherwise all real values are possible. So r minus 3. So for RF, for range of a function, let y is equal to f of x is equal to what? X square minus 9 upon x minus 3. Is it clear? Fx must be, so let y is equal to, so I can write what? Is equal to x square minus 9, I can write x plus 3 into x minus 3 upon x minus 3. X minus 3, x minus 3 cancel. So function of x is equal to what? X plus 3. So is equal to what? X plus 3. Range of function is what? X plus 3. Here you need x plus 3. So you can't include only 6. I will tell you how. Here what? X is not equal to 3. So you will write here. Here fx is what? X plus 3. X is not equal to 3. You know x is not equal to 3. And you want here what? X plus 3. So add both the sides. X plus 3 is not equal to 3 plus 3. Got the point? How I did? First fx I solved, that is x square minus 9 upon x minus 3. So you want what? X plus 3. I wrote x square minus 9, x plus 3 into x minus 3, a square minus b square, x square minus 3 square, that is what, x plus 3 into x minus 3. This x minus 3, x minus 3 cancels, so function is what? Now my function is x square, x plus 3, my function is x plus 3 only, fx is equal to x plus 3, x plus, this is fx is equal to x plus 3. Now I have to make this x plus 3, this function I have to make. But I know x is not equal to 3. So I will start from here. X is not equal to 3. Now I want what? X plus 3. So I am adding both sides, plus 3 plus 3. So it means x plus 3 is not equal to 6. And fx is what? X plus 3. So fx is not equal to 6. So range is what? Range of a function. All real numbers. But only 6 is not included. Range r minus 6. Is it clear? Now question number third part. Third part, you can see fx is equal to x plus 1 upon 2x plus 1. Fx is equal to x plus 1 upon 2x plus 1. So for domain of a function, fx must be a real number or x plus 1 upon 2x plus 1 must be a real number. It should be a real number means 2x plus 1 is not equal to 0. 2x plus 1 is not equal to 0. So 2x plus 1 minus 1 you can do is not equal to minus 1. Or you can say 2x is not equal to minus 1 or 2x plus 1 is not equal to 0. So 2x is not equal to minus 1. So x is not equal to minus 1 by 2. X can't be equal to minus 1 by 2. It is not equal to minus 1 by 2. Otherwise all values you can take. So R minus domain of a function is what? R minus minus 1 by 2 you have to exclude. R minus minus 1 by 2. For RF, for range of a function, start let y is equal to f of x is equal to x plus 1 upon 2x plus 1. Fx is equal to x plus 1 upon 2x plus 1. Or you can write here it's very complicated, so I can write y is equal to x plus 1 upon 2x plus 1. Multiply, cross multiply. Y into 2x plus 1 is equal to x plus 1. Or 2yx plus y is equal to x plus 1. Or you can write the value of x. So how will you write? 2xy minus x, 2xy. This x will come minus x is equal to what? 1 minus y, 1 minus y. Or x is common, 2y minus 1 is equal to 1 minus y. Or x value is what? 1 minus y upon 2y minus 1. X value is what? 1 minus y upon 2y minus 1. But you know x belongs to what? Real number. But you know x belongs to real numbers. So if it belongs to real number means what? 1 minus y upon 2y minus 1 must be a real number. 1 minus 1 upon 2y minus 1 must be a real number. You know x belongs to real number. So 1 minus y upon 2y minus must be a real number. It means if it is a real number, this is equal to this. This belongs to a real number and both are what? Equals. It is also, it should also be a real number. And if it is a real number means what? 2y minus 1 is not equal to 0. Now it is a complicated case. That's why we have solved like this. Full equation we have solved. And now we are doing 2y minus 1 is not equal to 0. So 2y is not equal to what? 1. So y is not equal to 1 by 2. Y only you can't take in range 1 by 2. All values are possible. So range of a function will be what? All real values only 1 by 2 is not possible. So R minus 1 by 2. Now fourth part you can see. It is given fx is equal to 4 plus x upon 4 minus x. Fx is equal to 4 plus x upon 4 minus x. So for df, for domain of a function, 4 plus x upon 4 minus x must be a real number. Must be a real number. It means 4 minus x is not equal to 0. Or x is not equal to 4. This minus x will go that side. So x is not equal to 4. So domain of a function is what? R minus only 4 values not included. So for RF, so for range of function, let y is equal to fx is equal to what? 4 plus x upon 4 minus x. Or I can write y is equal to 4 plus x upon 4 minus x. Wherever it is complicated, you can use direct cross multiply and write value of x first. Equate with right left hand side x. And then y, this side, right hand side. So it will be what? 4 minus x into y is equal to 4 plus x. Or I can write 4y minus xy is equal to 4 plus x. Or you can write 4y, this 4 will come this side, minus 4 is equal to x plus xy. Or you can write 4y minus 1 common is equal to x is common, 1 plus y. Or x value is 4y minus 1 upon 1 plus y. 4y minus 1 upon y plus 1 or 1 plus 1. So x value is what? 4 into y minus 1 upon y plus 1. Is it clear? So you know, but x belongs to what? Real number. But x belongs to real number. It means this will be also real number. But x belongs to real number. So y minus 1 upon y plus 1. Y plus must be a real number. This should also be a real number because both are equal. So must be a real number. When it will be a real number? When y plus 1 is not equal to 0. This can't be equal to 0. It means y is not equal to minus 1. Y is not equal to minus 1. Y plus 1 is not equal to 0 means y is not equal to minus 1. So in range you have to exclude only minus 1. So range of a function is what? All real numbers only you have to exclude minus 1. This is the range. Is it clear? Now question number 17. Question number 17. Find the domain and range of the following functions. Question number 17 first. Fx is equal to root of 16 minus x square. Root of 16 minus x square. So fx is equal to root of 16 minus x square. So for domain of a function, same you have to do. Fx must be a real number means 16 minus x square. And root must be a real number. When it will be a real number? When 16 minus x square is greater than equal to 0. It means 16 is greater than equal to x square, or x square is less than equal to 16. X square is less than equal to 16. Or here you can't do like this. X square is less than equal to 16. Here it is not x is less than equal to 16. Two values will come. So here comes the case. You have to write x here 16 minus x square is greater than equal to 0. So here it is minus x square, but I don't need here minus x square. So what will I do? Start from here. Take minus common because I need x square here, positive x square. So I will write x square minus 16 is greater than equal to. Now x square, I'm writing minus x square, minus is common. 16 minus x square, I'm writing what? Minus x square minus 16 is greater than equal to 0. Minus is common here because I want x square positive. So if I will multiply both sides minus, I want this full complete plus. So if I will tell you, multiply with minus 1. Multiply with minus 1 both sides. So you will get what? If you will multiply with minus 1 both the sides, this sign will also change. It will be minus 1 into this minus. So it will be what? Plus x square minus 16, sign will change. Greater than equal to will be what? Less than equal to minus 0 into minus 1 is what? 0. So x square minus 16 is less than equal to 0. X square minus 16 is less than equal to 0. So x plus 4 into x minus 4. X plus 4 into x minus 4 is less than equal to 0. Two values. X plus 4, x minus 4 is less than equal to 0. It means whenever the condition comes like this, x plus 4 into x minus 4 is less than equal to 0 means value can be between minus 4 to 4. So x value is between minus 4 to 4 only. So domain of a function is minus 4 to plus 4. Is it clear? Because they are saying you want in each and every case, if you put minus 4 to 4, any values I put minus 4. If I put minus 4 here, it will be 0. And here it will be minus 8. So it will be what? 0. So 0 is less than equal to 0. Condition is satisfied. If I put 4, it will be what? 4 minus 4. So this term will be 0, but this will be 8. So in this case also, it will be it is less than equal to 0. So in both the cases, if I put minus 5, it will be what? Minus 5 plus 4. That is what? Minus 1 and minus 9. Minus 4, minus 1 and minus 9. So it is what? Plus 9. Plus 9 is not less than equal to 0. So only between minus 4 to 4 you can take. Whenever this condition comes, x plus 4 into x minus 4 is less than equal to 0, or x plus 3 into x minus 3 is less than equal to 0. So you can write between minus 4 to 4 or minus 3 to 3, the values can come. You can't go more than minus 4. You can't go less than minus 4 and more than 4. Between minus 4 and 4 and 4 and minus 4 you can include. So domain of a function is what? Minus 4 comma 4. It is included. That's why I am putting this text. Minus 4 comma 4. Is it clear? Now for range of a function. Now for range of a function, fx must be a fx is equal to what? Let y is equal to fx is equal to root of 16 minus x square. So first equation you can give. square root of a real number is always square root of a real number. 16 minus x, if it is a real number, it means what? If this is a real number, means square root of a real number is always non-negative. So I can write here as square root of a, as a square root of a real number is always non-negative. Always non-negative. Always non-negative. So it can't come negative, na? The square root of a real number is always non-negative. So I can say y is always greater than or equal to 0. Or directly I can say what? 16 minus x square is greater than or equal to 0. Root of 16 minus x square is greater than or equal to 0. Or I can write what? Y is greater than or equal to 0. So squaring first equation. Square one first equation. Directly also you can do. Or like this also you can write. Or start from here. Y is greater than or equal to 0. So 16 minus y square is greater here. Y is greater than or equal to 0. So y square is also greater than or equal to 0. Squaring both the sides. Y square is greater than or equal to 0. Or 1 minute. You can do like this also. Here it is. As square root of a real number is always non-negative. So I can say y is greater than or equal to 0. Is it clear? Because y is equal to what? Fx is equal to root of 16 minus x square. And you know, square root of real number is always non-negative. Always non-negative means what? Y is greater than or equal to 0. It can be 0 or it can be greater than 0. But it can't be less than 0. So start from y is greater than or equal to 0. Now, squaring first equation. Is squaring equation number 1. We will get what? Y square is equal to what? Root of 16 minus x square whole square. So it will be 16 minus x square. So I can say this minus x square will come this side. So x square is equal to what? 16. This y square will go that way. So 16 minus y square. But you know, x square is greater than or equal to, x square is greater than or equal to 0. For all x belongs to, you can see here, x square is greater than or equal to 0. You can see here, values will be what? X is between what? Minus 4 to 4. So x square will be always what? Minus 4 square you will do, then also it is what? 16 greater than or equal to 0. Minus 3 if I put, then also it is greater than or equal to 0. 2 I will put, then also it is. So all the values of x, I know x square is greater than or equal to 0. For all x belongs to domain of function. Domain is what? Minus 4 to 4. Any value if you put, x square will be greater than or equal to 0. If x square is greater than or equal to 0, it means what? 16 minus y square. X square is greater than or equal to 0 means what? This is equal to this. So 16 minus y square is also greater than or equal to 0. So 16 minus y square is greater than or equal to 0. But here I tell you, I have to rub this. 16 minus y square is greater than or equal to 0. See here. I will solve it. 16 minus y square is greater than or equal to 0. Understood here? X square is equal to 16 minus y square. And I know x square is greater than or equal to 0. Because x value is between minus 4 to 4. Minus 4 and 4 are included. So, for all x belongs to df. So, I know x square is greater than or equal to 0. If it is greater than or equal to 0 means what? Both are equal. So, 16 minus y square is also greater than or equal to 0. But here it is minus y square. I don't want minus y square. So, minus I will take common. Here it will be y square minus 16 is greater than or equal to 0. If I multiply with minus 1 both the sides, then the sign will change. So minus, I am multiplying this. So minus minus will be what? Plus y square minus 16 is greater than or equal. So it will be less than or equal to 0 into minus 1. So 0. So y square minus 16 is less than or equal to 0. Or I can say y plus 4 into y minus 4 is less than or equal to 0. If this type of condition comes, y plus 4 into y minus 4 is less than or equal to 0. It means what? Y value is between what? Minus 4 to 4. Y value is between minus 4 to 4. But you know, all square root of a real number. Square root of a real number is always non-negative. Square root of a real number is always non-negative. So here it is what? Y is equal to what? Y is greater than or equal to 0. We know that y is greater than or equal to 0. So because y is what? Root of 16 minus x square. So y is greater than or equal to 0. So y is greater than or equal to 0, so I can't take minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. only I can take greater than equal to 0 value. I know y is between minus 4 to 4, but square root of a real number is always non-negative. Already we stated that y is greater than equal to 0, so only values we can take from 0 to 4. So you can write here, but y is greater than equal to 0, so we can take values only. We can't take minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, only from 0 to 4. So range of a function is what? 0 to 4. This is the answer. Like this here. Sorry. Now 17th second part. Second part you can see fx is equal to root of x square minus 9. So for domain of a function, fx must be a real number, means x square minus 9 and root must be a real number. Must be a real number. It means x square minus 9 is greater than equal to 0, or x plus 3, x minus 3 is greater than equal to 0. So here it is greater than equal to 0. If it is like this, x plus 3, x minus 3 is less than equal to 0, then the value of x is between minus 3 to 3. But here it is greater than equal to 0. X plus 3, x minus 3 is greater than equal to 0. So either you have to write x plus 3 is greater than equal to 0, or either x is less than equal to minus 3, either x is less than equal to minus 3, or either x is greater than equal to 3. Either x is less than equal to minus 3 or x is greater than equal to 3. So domain of a function, x plus 3, x minus 3 is greater than equal to 0. If x is less than equal to minus 3, less than minus 3, minus 4, minus 4 plus 3, minus 1, minus 1, and here minus 4, minus 3, minus 7, minus 7 into minus 1, plus 7, always greater than equal to 3. So either value is less than equal to minus 3 or greater than equal to 3. So domain of a function is equal to what? Less than minus 3, it means what? Minus 3 is the maximum value, less than minus 3, so go till infinity. Infinity we can't test, so minus infinity, bracket like this, minus 3, this bracket. Union, x is greater than equal to 3 means 3 is the minimum point and maximum it can go till infinity, we can't touch. So minus infinity comma minus 3, this bracket, here this bracket, here this bracket comma, here we are writing this bracket because sign are included equal. So this is the domain. For range of a function, for RF, for range of a function, let y is equal to root of x square minus 9. Let y is equal to root of x square minus 9, give equation number 1. And you know as a square root of a real number, as square root of a real number, is always non-negative, You know, all real valued function, x is real, y is real, so a square root of a real number is always non-negative. So I know y will be greater than equal to 0. Square root of a real number is always what? Non-negative. You know it will be a square root. It can't come. Y is equal to what? Root of x square minus 9. So y is greater than equal to 0. That is pakka. Square root of any number, it can't come in negative. You know that. So y is always greater than equal to 0 according to this. Squaring both the side, equation 1. Equation 1 whole square both the side. So it will be what? Y square is equal to x square minus 9. Or I can say x square is equal to what? Y square plus 9. X square is equal to y square plus 9. X square is equal to y square plus 9. So you know x square is greater, but x square is greater than equal to 0. X square is greater than equal to 0. X square is greater than equal to 0. For all x belongs to 1. But x square is greater than equal to 0. Here it is what? X square minus 9 is greater than or equal to 0. So x square you can see here. Any value you put. X is less than or equal to minus 3 you put. Or x is greater than or equal to 3 you put. If I put x is less than or equal to minus 3, let's say it is minus 4. If I am putting minus 4, minus 4 whole square is what? 16. If I put minus 3, that is what? Minus 3 whole square, that is 9. It is also greater than or equal to 0. If I put 3, then it's greater than or equal to 0, 9. 4 I put, then also it is greater than. So x square is greater than or equal to 0. So you know, if it is greater than or equal to 0, means it is equal to this. So y square plus 9 is greater than or equal to 0. So y square is greater than or equal to what? Minus 9. Y square is greater than or equal to minus 9, which is true for all y belongs to real numbers. You know, y square is greater than or equal to minus 9. That's pakka, whole square will be always greater than the negative number. Because it can't come negative anywhere. So, which is true for all, we can write which is true for all y belongs to real numbers. So also, now y square is greater than or equal to minus 9. Also, you know y is greater than or equal to 0. Y is greater than or equal to 0. So I can say range of a function is 1. Greater than or equal to 0. Y square will be greater than or equal to minus 9 only. Always the square will be what? More than negative number. It can't come negative. So always it is greater than minus 9. So range of function is what? Y is greater than or equal to 0. So RF will be what? 0 is included, greater than equal to 0, comma, infinity. This is the answer. Now question number third part. Third part you can see. Fx is equal to root 1 upon fx is equal to 1 upon root of 4 minus x square. So you can write for domain of a function, fx must be a real number, means 1 upon root of 4 minus x square must be a real number. It must be a real number. When it will be a real number? When 4 minus x square is not equal to 0. Or you can write 4 minus x square is greater than 0. If it is not equal to 0 also, it is greater than 0. 4 minus x square is greater than 0. Or I can write, I don't need here minus x square. So I am writing minus common, x square minus 4 is greater than 0. If here it is negative sign, I want also to multiply both sides with minus. So this sign will also change. So minus into minus is what? Plus. X square minus 4, this greater sign will be less than 0 into minus 1. So this one. So x square minus 4 is less than 0. So I can write x plus 2, x minus 2 is less than 0. If x plus 2, x minus 2 is less than 0, so value is between minus 2 to 2. Minus 2 and 2 are excluded. So domain of a function will be what? Domain of a function is what? Minus 2 to 2. This bracket, minus 2 to. Not minus 2 to 2, because minus 2 and 2 are not included. So domain of a function is what? Minus 2 to 2. So value is between minus 2 to 2. Now for RF, so domain of function ready here, df is equal to minus 2 to 2. Now for RF, range of a function. For RF, fx, let y is equal to fx is equal to 1 upon root of 4 minus x square. Again you have to write one line, as here it is y is equal to 1 upon root of 4 minus x square. So you have to write as square root of a real number. Square root of a real number is always, because fx is what? Equal to 1 upon root of 4 minus x square. So, pakka it will be what? Positive only. A square root of a real number is always non-negative. Always non-negative. Root, so in root it can't come negative here. Root value can't come in negative. So, if it can't come in negative, means what? Y is always greater than equal to 0. Y is greater than 0. It is always non-negative. Y is not greater than equal to 0. Because here 4 minus x square is in down. So y is greater than 0. It is not greater than equal to 0 is y is greater than 0. Consider this. Y is greater than 0. On squaring first equation. Equation was whole square both the sides. So y square is equal to what? 1 square 1 root of 4 minus x square whole square. That is what? 4 minus x square. So y square is equal to 1 upon 4 minus x square, or I can say 4 minus x square into y square is equal to 1, or I can say 4y square minus x square, y square is equal to 1, or you can say 4y square minus 1 is equal to x square, y square. Here what will I write? 4y square minus x square, y square is equal to 1, or I can write 4y square minus 1 is equal to x square, y square, or x square is equal to 1. This y square will come down, so 4y square minus 1 upon y square. X square you have to write. You have to write value of x. So x square is equal to 4y square minus 1 upon. So x square is equal to what? 4y square upon 4y square minus 1 upon y square. Y square cancel. 4 minus 1 upon y square. X square is what? 1 up 4 minus 1 upon y square. But you know, x square is greater than or equal to 0. Minus 2 to 2. If you will put minus 1 value, minus 1 is what? Whole square is what? 1. That is greater than or equal to 0. If I put 0, 0 is greater than or equal to 0. 1 if I put 1 square, that is what? Greater than or equal to 0. So you know, x square is equal to 4 minus 1 upon y square. But you know, x square is greater than or equal to 0. For all x belongs to df, you can write. For all x belongs to domain of function. Domain is what? Minus 2 to 2. Minus 2 and 2 are not included. Any value you put, x square will be greater than or equal to 0. It means 4 minus 1 upon y square is greater than or equal to 0. 4 minus 1 upon y square is greater than or equal to 0. So, four minus one upon y square is greater than or equal to zero. Or you can take LCM. Here it is the LCM. Y square. Here it is 4. So 4y square minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. Or I can say 4y square minus 1 is greater than or equal to y square into 0. That is what? 0. So 4 square minus 4y square minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. So I can write what? 4y square minus 1 square. So I can write this 2y whole square minus 1 whole square. A square minus by. 2y plus 1. 2y minus 1. 2y plus 1. 2y minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. So I can say either y is less than or equal to minus 1 by 2. So either y is less than or equal to minus 1 by 2, or y is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. Y is less than or equal to minus 1 by 2, or y is greater than 1 by 2. Both values are coming. Y is less than or equal to minus 1 by 2, or y is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. But already we said square root of a real number is always non-negative. Y is greater than 0. So I can't take y is less than or equal to minus 1 by 2. I want only positive values. So I can write y is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. Only I can take y is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. I can't take this value. So y is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. So what will be the range of function? So range of function will be greater than or equal to 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is included, comma, infinity. So this is the range. Thank you.